tuned in to www.oghuskyradio.com, broadcasting live from the east side of Los Angeles, worldwide. Live interviews every Thursday night. We got some real hip-hop motherfuckers up in here sometimes, man. Like this cat. Go ahead and introduce yourself, man.
What up, everybody? Delhi, DUI crew. D's up. Everything else down.
What form of hip-hop expression do you represent, man?
Represent the b-boy and the graffer.
Definitely, man.
Because sometimes I boogie down.
Oh, I didn't know that, dog. You didn't say that, man? What was was
boogieing down all the time.
B-boy first or a graph writer first?
A little bit of both. Kamikaze on that ass.
Yep. Hold on. Give me 1 second, man. 1 again, OGHuskyRadio.com. Had that video all crispy clear and shit. I had to, you know, scramble it up a little bit. keep motherfuckers on their toes, man. What does DUI stand for, man? Because I got one in 2005. I don't think it's the same thing, though, and shit. Right? Yeah, you did the AA classes and all that shit. And no, nigga, Top Rank knows about that shit.
That's how we make all the rest of the graphers pay up. But nah, check it out. DUI originally stands for driving you insane. But there's a lot of other meanings. We got die, you idiots. Don't you ignore. Don't you imitate. Demons using ink. Dumping until I kill. Plenty more, man.
Why'd you decide to get in that crew, man? How do you know?
DUI originally started in Lincoln Heights and came to my hometown, which is Montebello, in the early 2000s. I'm originally from Montebello, so when it came to my street, which is Greenwood, I felt like, dang, I got to get in the best crew that's in my city and in my block. So there was no other crew that I had to look for. DUI was it. They were doing it heavy, and all my homies that I grew up with were in DUI, so I felt like I had to get in that crew.
Who put you on? Who put you on the crew?
The homie that put me on was my best friend and a homie that I grew up with for years, which is my homie Simi, and another compadre of mine, Eri, which is in Arizona right now, which is doing his own thing. But those are the two big influences that put me on to DUI.
And who got you into graph? Like, where does it start for you, man? Like, growing up in Montebello, who'd you see up, or, you know what I mean? How did you get into the whole graph game and shit?
Well, growing up in Montebello, you see a lot of crews like MFT, CTE, TCA, WDS. The list goes on, you know. For all you Montebello riders that are old school, you guys should know what's up. But I got into it because of my older brother, which is Hintz 304 from CTE MFT, which is no longer in California or in the States no more. Due to a lot of drugs, due to a lot of fucking around, ended up getting deported. But that was my influence since middle school. Since I was like 11 years old, he always put me up on game with graph. Even though he was the older brother that didn't want the little brother to do it, you know, I'm always going to do what the older brother doesn't want me to do. So that's how it went down.
Are you a bomber, piecer, man? What's your title, dog? What would you say you are?
I love it all, but I'm not going to lie. I'm a grimy mobber, man. I love to tag it. I love to do throw-ups, and I love to bomb it, man. But I also like pieces, but that's not my cup of tea. I'm more of a bomber.
So grimy, two-color, tag spots. You're also known for the quote-unquote hot boy spots, dog. You know what I mean? You got those on lock for a while and shit, dog.
Yeah, yeah. I love the hot spots. I love cars honking at my ass. I love people calling me a motherfucker. I love for people to pass by at 10 o'clock in the morning, see me on the side of the street, bombing it up, that shit.
Let's talk about that, man, because in 2013, man, you had a nice run, man. What did that entail, man? How much time were you dedicating so, like, people will know what they have to do to get, you know what I mean?
Put it like this. You wake up, you eat, you sleep, and you shit graffiti. This is what it was about. I was waking up at the Home Depot like if I was one of those spice out workers. But instead of working, I was working the workers for some of that paint. And after that, I'll just look for anything in sight that I could crush. Anything that looked nice, anything that looked hot, anything that looked like I'd go run, you bet your ass Deli's name was going to be up on it by the end of the night.
So we're talking like bus mission, right? You're still doing a bus mission. And then, because I was asking you too, did you plan like, oh, this is, I got to hit this, you know, strategize what area you're going to hit. It was just as you rolled through wherever it took you, or?
It was just a lot of bus mission, a lot of foot walking, a lot of calluses on my feet. Just took a lot of grimy work. If you want the spots, you're going to get them. It doesn't take any set out route. It doesn't take any plan. You already know what you gotta do. You gotta be up and about. You gotta upscale every single part of LA. You can't just be stuck to downtown or to where you're from. You gotta rise and be above that. You gotta get up everywhere.
Would you consider it a graph career or is it a hobby? What is graph to you, man?
To me, it was more of a rush. Yeah. I like to do it while I'm laughing. I was always fucked up or high or on some type of substance when I was doing it. So you'll catch me cracking the fuck up while I'm doing it. You can tell any of the homies that went with me. They'll tell you, Deli's crazy. This guy's fucking busting up while doing a bomb. What the fuck's wrong with them? Because I love cars honking at me. I love people telling me, like, what the fuck are you doing? It's 10 o'clock in the morning.
Because you were faded while doing it, you ever have to go back to fix it?
Fuck no, it is what it ain't, you know? You leave that shit. You gotta worry about that. That's just one bomb out of 100.
At no rules needed. At no rules needed.
At no rules needed. Anybody wants to get at me, that's my Instagram name. No rules needed. All day, every day.
OGSGradio.com. Will you ever stop doing illegals?
Well, you know, due to certain fucking courts that I'm not gonna name, yeah. I had to stop, you know? Motherfuckers trying to get me to do time and shit, so I had to take a little pause, but believe you're gonna see a lot of them. Waz being rocked, a lot of artsy shit coming out now, less grimy shit, more productional shit, but you know?
So we could be on the lookout for the artsy farty Dali one, like the nice paintings.
Yeah, not even the though 2 to 3 minutes and shit. Even though I don't want to, but you know, it is what it ain't, man. I ain't trying to eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
What's the longest you've been out of spot, man?
Fuck. If I'm at a yard, I'll take all day. I'll even sleep at that motherfucker. But if I'm at a hot spot where people are gonna see it, I ain't taking no longer than 2 to 3 minutes, man. I got a fat cap. There's no need for none of that shit. You get in, you get out. Be quick or be dead.
What's the one of the dopest spots you could think of offhand right now, like that you're happy or still rocking it?
There's one right there in the art district. I'm not going to quote the street because I don't want you guys out there to cap my shit.
Go look for that shit. I go out of your way and shit, right?
You already know. There's one right there, right when you get into the art district, man. It's on a mural. Surprisingly, it's been rocking this long because there is a couple of haters out there that don't like my shit.
Are there rules for what you do? Like, you know what I mean? As far as going over anything or, you know what I mean?
I mean, plain and simple for me is there is rules that guys put out there, that other graphics put out there, which is like throwies over outlines, bombs over throwies, pieces or burners over a bomb. But to me, it's like to each his own. And if you're OG, then there ain't no rules. You know what I mean? Like, if I've been mobbing longer than you, Spence out, but you're getting capped.
Damn.
How is your argument towards me? I've been riding longer than you. You're just new in the game. You're getting up, so you got to learn from shit like that, you know? We've been doing this. People that are older than me or been doing it longer than me are not going to be satisfied with somebody that did something just because they're barely getting up or they're using colors. It's a wall. It's graffiti. It is what it is. Ain't nobody going to go visit you in jail when you get caught up or nobody's paying you to go do this. Nobody's waking you up in the morning to tell you to go graph it. So there is no rules, but at the same time, you do got to respect landmarks and OGs. Those are the only rules I got to imply. Besides that, have fun.
Why do you do it?
I did it because of the rush. I love to see people watch me do it. I love to hear the car honks. I love to fucking feel the air of 18-wheelers passing by my ass while I'm bombing a freeway spot. I love to run out of Home Depot with like thousands of dollars worth of shit. I love to fucking have pain in my backpack. I love to get drunk in an illegal spot where the cops could arrest me. I love all that grimy shit.
So doing it is more fun or coming back to see it rocking the next day?
Doing it, obviously. Fuck coming back. Let the people tell you about that shit. Let the streets talk.
Do you patrol your spots?
Never.
Never. Just fuck it is what it is.
Let the Instagram and the Flickr picture people take care of that.
Is there anything you won't hit?
Bridges. I'm always too fucked up to hit anything where I gotta be taking care of my balance. I'm too fucked up for shit like that. I hit a bridge or something like that, you guys will hear about it on the 6 o'clock news. Hearing about, oh, local tagger fell off the bridge due to intoxication. Chai kids, that ain't me. Sorry for your luck.
Craziest shit. Well, story, man, while doing what you do, man.
Sexually or graffiti-wise?
Everything. Fuck it, we gotta hear both of them now. Fuck the dumb shit.
All right, check it out, man. Me and my boy hitting some shit towards towards Harborside.
Okay.
Hitting some shit. Some girls roll up to us randomly. While I'm hitting some shit, using some colors, trying to get funky with it, you know, trying to be a little.
All right, now some real shit. Were you hitting the colors before the chicks came or when they showed up? Like, oh no, I do.
As soon as I saw chicks, I started pulling out greens, pinks. Fuck, I even pulled out a shit stained brown.
go for it. That's some real shit, though.
Check it out, though. I'm hitting some shit. These girls are like, oh shit, your shit's nice. Well, could you do this? Could you do my name? I'm like, shit, hell yeah. Just let me finish my shit up real quick. Hold on. So I finish my shit up. Me and my boy end up fucking around with these girls. The next day, they're like, oh, I ended up asking them, like, how do you guys know about graffiti? Oh, my brother and my cousin are so-and-so. Ended up being some enemies. True shit.
That's usually how it
Dopest
works.
Dopest day of my life. I was like, fuck yeah. Hey, well, check it out. What are you doing next Friday?
OGSKRadio.com, Instagram, at No Rules Needed.
So no rules are ever needed in this game. Got rules, then you're doing the wrong game.
So we could look, though. Now we could be on the lookout for, you know what I mean, the artsy fartsy canvas work. You're doing sketches, though, right now?
Yeah, I'm doing sketches now for a couple of graffiti stores. I'm not going to put out there on blast, you know, but I've been doing a lot of sketches for graffiti stores, a couple of females, you know, that love art. And unfortunately, that's what I could do now due to a fucking shit that I got to do for court and requisitions I got to meet for the law. But, man, that shit's unfortunate because if I didn't get caught this last time, a lot of LA mobbers will be hating my fucking guts right now. And that's a guarantee because I was doing a lot of heavy shit. But fuck it. It is what it ain't and it ain't what it is.
Well, thanks for coming through, man. And you know, thanks for all the work you put down for fucking, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
the part of hip-hop that, you know, people don't really fucking like to acknowledge and shit.
You already know, man. DUI crew all day. That's what I live for. That's what I fucking love doing. I always had to throw the crew up on the map.
And the name Dally, what does that name mean? What the hell is that, man?
Well, if you know what's up, it means deli market. You know, you want to eat a sandwich, get your ass to the deli market.
How did that name come about?
Well, back then when I was, how old was I? I was like 14 or 15. I was writing a real complex name. I used to write Relic, which is fucking too long. Too out of this world. I had to fucking think of a name that was just four letters and simple. So, it took like, I would say about like two blunts and like a 40 or two. Watching a couple of gangster movies, Goodfellas, one of them. And then I was just like, fuck it, man. Deli's fucking everywhere. Every corner I look at, I see deli. So why not write a name that everybody's been seeing up? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Commercial-wise. Okay. Now I'm writing a name that people could see graffiti-wise. Four letters, simple. If you can't pronounce it, you're fucking illiterate.
At No Rules Needed. Thanks for coming through. Any shout-outs, Doug?
Any shout-outs, first of all, to all the homies from DUI Crew, from my homie Curse, all the way down to my homie Queso, to the homies from CSD, from Pulse, all the way down to Lear and Coder, to the homies from SKA, all the way from Foam to the homie Pryor. Everybody in East LA and Montebello, much love. You guys keep me going. I'll keep you guys going.
Peace. OGSK Radio. Stay posted. More interviews to come.